So now I am going to explain Shiva and Shakti.
Yes.
Shiva and Shakti are the permanent entities. They are the only the permanent entities. You cannot see Shiva and Shakti. The Shakti is the permanent energy filled in the cosmos. When you cool down the energy assumes mass. That is, the air layer comes out. From Akash, the air layer comes out. When you condense this air layer, it becomes a fire. When you still condense the fire, it becomes a liquid. When you still condense, it becomes solid. So solid, liquid, fire, air are the different forms of Shiva and Shakti. So, this assuming form from the unseen cosmos and Parashakti is called creation. When you heat this earth element, it becomes liquid and solid disappears. In again, you heat liquid, it goes into vapor, and liquid disappears and enters into fire, and fire also comes to air. When the air is also further and heated, the atomic structure will be lost and all become energy called O. This is not called, this is called not destruction. You mind that word, destruction is available only in Vedanta and all other philosophies. G God, G for generation, O for operations, D for no. You cannot destroy anything. Energy can neither be destroyed nor be destroyed, but can be changed. How can you destroy? Only dissolution. Only dissolution. The energy form is there. That is, you call it Parashakti. The energy form, when it condenses, it becomes of five other four elements. When you heat it, it goes inside. It is called dissolution. In Vedanta, people wrongly hold Shiva as a destructor. Shiva is not the destructor. Shiva is the compound of nine principle, and the destroying agent is Rudra. Nataraja principle, Rudra is having this fire bowl, banging bowl in his hand. This is Rudra. That is, if you increase heat, everything will disappear. If you decrease heat, everything will come up, come down. That is why Saint Manikya Vasara, one Siddha in Tamil told, Vana, hi manna, hi valiya, hi uliya, hi una, hi uira, hi unmayima, inmayika. So everything is Shiva Shakti, manifestation of Shiva Shakti. Air is manifestation of Shiva Shakti, fire is manifestation, liquid is manifestation. Your jiva and your the flesh is also. Because it is also made of five panchabhutas. Panchabhutas, combination of panchabhutas. So everything is Shiva. The same Manikya Vasara says. So this is actually the different forms of this Shiva and Shakti. The qualities of Shiva Shakti called Tanmatra, that is also Shiva Shakti. Panchabhuta qualities also Shiva Shakti, qualities of Shiva Shakti. Akasha is having sound form. Fire is having this, air is a form, sound plus Sparsha. Fire sound, Sparsha plus Rupa. Liquid sound, Sparsha, Rupa and this taste, Swadhi. Then earth sound, Sparsha, Rupa, then Swadhi plus what we call every five feelings are there. Smell. That also Saint Manikya Vasara says in his form, Shiva and Shakti are in the name, they are the sound, they are the Sparsha, they are the Rupa. Yes, all of these qualities of Panchabhuta. You are living in Shiva Shakti. Because you are enjoying life, he is a multi-millionaire. He is having four cars, two wives and ten children. He has to marry. All are in the Shiva Shakti form only. You can enjoy this world only through sound, Sparsha, all these things only. All our enjoyments are within these five qualities only. Because this sound you hear through your ear, he is deaf, one quality out there. Your nose is not, you cannot smell. This tongue is not properly tasting, then he cannot enjoy. He is multi-crore millionaire, his tongue is not is not able to enjoy the chicken piece from star water. What has happened? So this is, you are living within this Panchabhoot, this Shiva Shakti. You are enjoying the Shiva Shakti. You are this Andhakarma also to receive Shiva Shakti. Just like a fish living in water, you are living in Shiva Shakti. When you get linked within Shiva, then your third eye opens. Vasi also is that. Vasi, Parashakti, see Shiva. When you link with that, that is the process. In this Panchakshara, C stands for Shiva, Va for stands for Parashakti, Ya for your this Jiva. Nama, this empirical matter, Dhirodhanama and Maya. When you cross Dhirodhanama and Maya, when you get connected to Shiva, then only your third eye will open, then only Vasi will come. So this is the highest scientific way of Shiva Shakti experience, I think. What do you think? Is there anything available in, you have read many books, you have many, have you seen such a, this is available in Tamil Agamas. Whatever is in Tamil Agamas and what Saint Manijavasa, that I told here. Okay?